So in this passage from Romans chapter 6, a passage that we read at the great vigil of Easter as the epistle lesson, and every year at that time, we talk about being baptized into death. But I want to kind of dwell a little bit since we're in the Lenten season, on the first few sentences that start this out. What then are we to say? Should we continue in sin in order that grace may abound? By no means. How can we who died to sin go on living in it? Do you not know that all of us who have been baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? And so the Old Testament narrative that's in the background here is, so again, we have to remember, so he's Paul earlier in the letter, he's talked about in chapter 4 as kind of the Abraham chapter. And then in chapter 5, he actually rolls the tape back all the way to Adam. And now in chapter 6, he's going to kind of have a theology that unpacks the Passover narrative, and specifically the journey through the Red Sea. And so this, for Paul, this is in the back of kind of in the back of his mind as he talks about being baptized into a death and going into the waters and coming out the other side into a new risen life in Christ. And it says that in Jesus, we are brought into a new exodus from death into life. And in a sense, basically, once you've got on the other side of the waters, you don't live like Egyptians anymore. You don't live like slaves anymore. On the other side of the waters of the Red Sea, the Israelites had to learn how to live as Israelites, as a people under God's tutelage and God's way, which he then reveals to them in Sinai, and then to bring them into the promise of new life in the land promised to Abraham. So for Paul, again, he's rooting the Christian story. He's telling us kind of the who we are and the when we are in the story, as I talked about in a recent sermon. The who, we are the people of God who have been brought through the waters of death, the Red Sea, an impossible way. We've been brought through the impossible way of death itself into a new and risen life in Jesus. And the when we are in the story is we're in the wilderness period. We are in the place of having been delivered. I mean, the armies of Egypt, they've washed up on the other shore. They are behind us. Egypt is in the rearview mirror. So the when is Egypt is behind us. The promised land, read promised life, is ahead of us. And in the meantime, we're learning to live. We're learning to be resurrection people. We're learning to be Israel people, promised land people, as we learn God's ways in the wilderness. And we're called to allow the glory of God, right, which evokes the pillar of fire at night, and the pillar of cloud, and the glory of God that comes down on the tabernacle tent. So that glory of God, which led the people of Israel from place to place, that same glory of God has been revealed in Jesus and leads us on our journey towards God's promise of new and eternal life for us in Jesus. So that's the who and the when. And so this is the what's at the background of this wonderfully joyful passage that that in the background, of course, also is the song of Miriam at the Red Sea, and that song of triumph of just a people who've been delivered by an impossible way from an overwhelming enemy that they couldn't defeat on their own, but now have the opportunity to live in freedom and in joy for the rest of their days. And that Paul is saying that is what our life in Jesus is supposed to be: living in freedom, living in joy, learning to be a human being in the image of Jesus Messiah. A reading from St. Paul's letter to the Romans. What then are we to say? Should we continue in sin in order that grace may abound? By no means. How can we who died to sin go on living in it? Do you not know that all of us who have been baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? Therefore, we have been buried with him by baptism into death, so that, just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, so we too might walk in newness of life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we will certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. We know that our old self was crucified with him so that the body of sin might be destroyed and we might no longer be enslaved to sin. For whoever has died is freed from sin. But if we have died with Christ, we believe that we will also live with him. We know that Christ, being raised from the dead, will never die again. Death no longer has dominion over him. The death he died to sin once for all. But the life he lives to God. So you also must consider yourselves dead to sin and alive to God in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.